So here in FL Studio, as you can see, we have at the top here, we have the time, the BPMs. And BPM stands for beats per minute. And this defines how fast or how slow your track is. So everything that goes into this, so the project that you have loaded will be synced to this time. So if you want a faster project, you have to increase the BPMs. If you want a slower project, you have to increase the decrease the BPMs. And when you say time of the MIDI, it kind of does not make sense to say it that way, or it's not the right way to define the time of the project. Because as you can see here, I have 140, and all the MIDI that I put here will be played at 140 BPMs. So I can have the same MIDI notes. So let's say that I have these MIDI notes. And if I play this now, there's no sound here. But if there was a sound, it would play at 4 beats at 140 BPM per minute, or BPM, which is beats per minute. And if I slow this down for, let's say, 100, this will play also at every beat. And but the difference is that now we have a different BPM. So you cannot, it's not correct to say to change the time of MIDI, but the time of the project overall. And yeah, so that's what I wanted to clarify, the two differences. One is that time is relative. So when we are talking about MIDI here, we are talking about steps, beats, bars, half steps, half beats, and so on. All these measures that we have here, this is what we are talking about when we talk about MIDI here in the piano roll. But then, if I change the speed or the BPMs of the entire project, you will not see any difference here in the way the BPM is laid, or the MIDI is laid out. The only difference is that it's going to play slower or faster. That's the only difference. But when you want to make your track faster, you have to change the BPMs. If you want to make the track slower, you have to decrease the BPMs. And if you do want to, let's say that you are talking about MIDI, I want to make the MIDI longer or shorter, what you have to do is just move the MIDI around. So like this. This way, we would have the half the time, because we spaced out the notes. So before it was every step, let's move this to beat. So before was every beat, now is every two beats. And we kept the same time, but we changed the MIDI notes so that it was half the time. If you want faster, what we can do is go, for instance, let's go to 1.5 beats, and we can put it this way. So this way we will have the four notes in two beats rather than in four beats, or even eight beats. So I hope that that difference was clarified, but that's basically how you can change the time is here. There are a couple of options here. If you right click, you can see the tab, and there's a bunch of options here that we can set for ease of use. So let's say that I want to 100 BPMs and I want to go for 140. I can do so very easily without dragging, clicking and dragging and dropping, dragging up and down to change the BPM. I can go to a normal, let's say, because when we open FL Studio, it starts with 140. Let's say that I want to go to 90. I just click here and automatically sets me to 90, and then I can fine tune this as I want. So that's the options here. We also have a tab, and this is very nice. This is where usually I start my beats, and I would go and let's say I have a an idea that I have in mind, and I start to play around with some piano or something like that, and then I go and I start tapping to see how fast it is that I'm feeling the vibe of the track, and then I can go here and tap something like that. If I want it faster, this is too fast. So as you can see, and that's basically how I do it. Sometimes it's the best way to do it. So let's say that I want to have, let's say that I'm playing around with some keys and I have some notes here. Something like that. Let's say that I wanted to record that rhythm. What I would do is go here to tab. Something like that. And I can see this 140. I mean, I'm not sure if 140 would match what I was looking for, but then I can go ahead and start playing around with the rhythm that I had in mind and get an idea of what was the BPM that I was thinking of. So that's a good way to set the tempo of your track without having to guess or try to match the tempo. You just tap it with your mouse and with your finger and you have a good idea of the BPMs that you wanted.